Welcome to my channel. I'm Dee, and today we are going on a major grocery haul. This is the biggest grocery haul I've done in years, and I'm trying to revert to monthly grocery shopping. I don't have that perfected yet. I do a lot of recipes during the month that sometimes require ingredients I don't usually have on hand. So I may have to stop at the store a couple times during the month, but just for a couple of things. Now, because I'm trying to stockpile, I went through what I have and I actually made like an Excel list. You can have it on paper. And I put the types of meat I had and how much, and also their location, because I live in an apartment and my freezer is yay big. But I have a huge upright freezer that my daughter is kind enough to store in her kitchen. But it's like a 15-minute walk away. But that allows her to use my freezer because it's too big for me. I don't need that much. And it still allows me to stockpile, but I need to know what I have over there. It's the same thing, I guess, if you had a freezer in your house. You want to know what's at the bottom of it or at the back of it. So that's what I did. I then made a grocery list, and yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and film. It's 6:30 in the morning here, folks. The store we're going to, I live in a little town, is quite a ways away. It's a 45-minute drive, and it snowed. Doesn't look like the weather's going to be all that great. So it's kind of scary, a little bit, because they're not huge main roads that we take. But we are going to do it. We're going to have a good time, and we're going to take you along. We have no idea what the lineups are going to be because they've imposed stricter regulations on us that we need to follow. So let's get out there and see what we can accomplish today. Okay, so we're on our way. It is 7:43, so I was hoping to be there by 8. I'm hoping maybe 8:30, so we aren't going to get there for when it opens. I'm hoping there's no lineup. During the first wave, there were hundreds of people in line, so I'm hoping that doesn't happen. The roads, for the most part, aren't bad, but we're running into areas where they're kind of dicey. These are like Class B roads, which means they don't get 24-hour maintenance, and all the Class A roads get maintenance first and then ours. So, and if Jesse looks forward, like, you go up some pretty big hills, and some of them, you know, you're kind of scared as you get to the top. If it gets a little icy, and then going down, joyride sometimes. It's there's a few nasty side roads too, and I'm trying to avoid them. We just want to get there safely. Okay, we're here almost half an hour late, but there are no lines. This is seniors hours, and I qualify for seniors, so I'm really happy about that, and we're going to go in and get some shopping done. So we are in Costco, and it is dead. It's seniors, and there's not many people here, and it's absolutely wonderful. Okay, we are almost done. This is my cart. Pretty well full, and Jesse has a cart too with some of the big stuff, just a couple more items, and then we are heading for the checkouts. So my budget, I went over it and counted things up, and I thought $500. Well, that didn't work out.
It came to $664.32. So I'm about $164 over budget on that store. And we still have another store to go. However, there are a few things, not $144 worth, that I bought at Costco because they were cheaper, that they were going to be cheaper than the grocery store. So let's hope I can keep the next trip down. This is scary. I don't think I've ever spent that much at Costco. We're now going to No Frills, which is a chain store, but it tends to have a little bit lower prices, and we're going to try and get the rest of our stuff there. Okay, so we just arrived at No Frills. We're going to grab a cart, and I'm terrified. I've spent so much money, but there's some things I cannot do without, so I need to go in here. So we are done. This is another $200. That was over my budget as well. But hey, what are you going to do? And there were several things I could not get that I'm going to have to get locally. They were just out of it. So it is what it is, and we'll see in a minute.
Okay, so we are done our shopping. It's not as bad as I thought. I had figured out I would be spending about $800. So when I spent $660 something at Costco, I was like panicking. But I spent quite a bit less at No Frills because I did pick up some of the things at Costco. So it came to $857.37, which is only $57.37 over budget, which isn't too bad. I thought I'd end up a couple hundred over budget. I did get a few extra things, but they were needed. But there's also a few things they just didn't have at either Costco or No Frills that I will have to pick up maybe this week at this small local store. But it's 11:17. We got up and had to get up at 5:30 in the morning to shower and get ready to come here. I thought the stores would be so packed. We are currently under provincial stay-at-home orders, and what that means is we are only supposed to go out for essential work. If it's a possibility that you can work from home, you must. You are allowed to go out for groceries, for medical appointments. You can go for a walk, exercise, or walk your dog, and that's about it. So I had thought, you know, with the first wave, there were lineups of hundreds of people at Costco. So I thought, okay, we have to get there really early. But you know what? It was dead. It was empty in there. And I went, it was actually really nice because we were walking in from 8 to 9 is seniors. And we were walking in, and the woman said, oh, 8 to 9 is seniors. And I said, good, because I'm a senior. And she said, oh, well, you don't look like it. She was complimentary. And I said, oh, thank you. Mind you, I was wearing a mask, so, you know, all you could see was my eyes. But it felt kind of good. So that's the perfect time to go. Costco was well stocked. It was nice and safe. Oh, all of our stores are at 25% capacity. And the government is being really strict in doing inspections, so they're really watching their numbers. But I was pretty proud of people for not, you know, rushing to stores and that. Jesse and I are trying to do it, you know, just I'll have to stop for a couple of things, but basically we should be good for about a month, maybe more on some, well, obviously more on some things. So once we get home, we're going to open up the trunk and show you everything we have. It is packed. So there's just Jesse and I. And what's going to happen now is once we get home, we have. I live on the third floor. We don't have an elevator. So Jesse and I will probably have to do
a whole lot of trips of those dinners. That is going to be complete torture because, yeah, because not only is it up the stairs, but I'm on the very back of the building too, so it's walking from the front to the back and going up all the stairs. It's going to be tiring, but it'll be such a relief. And going into, you know, the second wave and knowing I have surgery and that coming up, I feel so much secure, so much more secure because I do have a nice stockpile. I'm going to put up the videos for the hauls separately so it's not a super, super long video. And we're just going to get home and show you the back end. So check this out. It's packed. We're going to tell you, we're not just going to bring it in. We're just going to finish the video and I'll tell you how many trips it took us up to get up to the third floor. So we'll see you in a minute. Okay, so everything is up. Not everything is put away yet. It ended up taking 10 trips, each of us. So if one person did it, they would have been up and down the stairs 20 times, and it's not just one flight. We're exhausted. Yeah, I feel like it's 9:30, 10 o'clock at night, and I'm getting ready for bed, but it's only about 1:30. So I'm gonna get busy and process all my meat and things like that. I want to thank you for joining us. Check out the videos of the hauls we got from this and also what I'm doing with everything I bought. I really appreciate it. Take care, and until next time.